Hello YouTubers, Rogan Kid Jr. here, and in today's video, I wanted to discuss the option of, was the Apocalypse DLC released too early? I mean, we have seen quite a few issues since the Apocalypse DLC has been released to live servers for premium users, and of course the people who own Revolution. There has been a lot of issues arising since the release of the Apocalypse DLC, and I personally feel like the DLC was maybe released a little bit early. I mean, we just got the second half of Turning Tides with the two new maps. So we just got new content literally like not even a month ago, because it released on like January 30th, right? And now we get the entire Apocalypse DLC, five new maps, three infantry maps, and then two air assault maps, the new game mode, two new bombers, seven new weapons. Yeah, something like that. No, I forget how many weapons. New weapons. Like a bunch of new stuff, but half of it isn't like really up to par. I mean, as everybody knows by now, there is a hell of a lot of microstuttering when you're getting hits on enemies, and it gets really annoying, borderline unplayable on certain systems. Now, I know not everybody is experiencing this, so before anybody says, oh, you have a shit PC, get a better PC, no, it's been addressed by the developers that there is an issue with the tracking of the new assignments. Well, at least they think that's the problem. So every time you score a hit, you score points, it microstutters, your CPU spikes, and you get those, like, 20 millisecond freezes, but still, it is quite annoying. On top of that, one of the other issues that I have been experiencing, and I think a lot of other people have been experiencing from the conversations I had with these people, there is a lot of lag in Passchendaele. Like, when spawning, it is just unreal how much there's lag, and like visual lag. When you spawn in on a teammate on flag, it's just like, it stutters, and then you spawn, and then boom, you're there. And there's also lag, like, just in the map in general, so maybe optimize the map a little bit more, I don't know. It's really annoying to me. I've been playing quite a bit to unlock the new weapons, but really, I don't really feel like playing with the issues that have been plaguing Battlefield since the release of Apocalypse DLC. I mean, it's only 2 days in, and not even 1 day in. No, 2 days, because I'm recording this the day before. So yeah, it's only like 2 days in, and like, I don't even want to play the new maps anymore because of the issues that have come along with this update. And a couple of other things I noticed, so something really stupid, okay? A capitalization mistake on the LMG 0818 low weight is driving me absolutely insane. It looks really stupid. All the other letters are capitalized except the L on the beginning of the gun name. I don't know why. Like, I know there's a lot of things to think about when they're making a DLC, but I mean, they released it so early after the second half of Turning Tides. Like, I feel like they could have used like maybe another month, get everything up to like squeaky clean, everything works beautifully, and we get an amazing launch of the DLC, except we have this, which nobody had time to hype up for. Everybody's a little bit disappointed, and you get these insane microstuttering issues and all of the other little things that were overlooked. Something else, you can't see the weapon assignments in the menus. So if you go customize your class and you look at the weapons that you haven't unlocked yet, for some reason you can't see the weapon assignments. You actually have to be in a game to see the weapon assignments. Like, I don't know why that is. You usually are always able to see the weapon assignments in the customize your soldier tab in the menus, but since the Apocalypse DLC, you can't see those. Nope. And also, there was a tweet from Mr. Pro Westy that on the stream it was said that they didn't have the time needed to implement operations, and there was no historical link between any of the maps. Now, I get the historical link part, but just the fact that they said that they didn't have the time to implement operations, it makes me think, like, well, why did you release the DLC if you still had stuff you wanted to add into the DLC? And now it's out, and people are a little bit disappointed. It's not up to par. There's bugs, there's microstuttering, there's all these issues arising with the Apocalypse DLC. And then you're saying you didn't have the time to implement something that possibly, if you had waited a little bit longer, you would have had the time to implement maybe in operations. Even if the maps don't have any historical links, I'm sure people would have loved to see those maps in operations. Personally, I would have. And then secondly, it would have probably been a much, much smoother launch for the Apocalypse DLC. Because let's be honest here, the Apocalypse DLC launch has not been smooth whatsoever. So, you know, just a bunch of little things that made me think, like, why did they already release this? We just got new content like 20 days ago. Now they're releasing a whole new other Apocalypse DLC. There's no hype for it. Everybody tried all the stuff in the CTE already. There's a bunch of issues with it. But anyways, I'm rambling at this point. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of the Apocalypse DLC launch, what you think of the DLC in general, if you think that it was too early to release it. And while you're down there, be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Don't forget to join the Discord server. Link in the description down below. And as always, thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.